Tonight, we are also delighted to honor Jim and Lisa Spigarelli with our Vision to Action Award. This is the highest recognition awarded by the Center and reserved for those who have, through their leadership, vision, and commitment, demonstrated the highest ethical standards of conduct driven by shared values and virtues to which we all aspire. It's not every year that we honor a couple for this award, and our recognition this year acknowledges the importance of the commitment of family as an essential in making a difference at home, in community, and in society. For more than a half century, Jim and Lisa have dedicated their lives to family, to Greater Kansas City, and to the national and international professional commitments they have loved and nourished. Lisa's work, which began in 1973, teaching more than three dozen third graders in one of the poorest schools in our region, led to her next career as a full-time homemaker, and then a few years after that, on to professional work and assisting in clinical trials and informed consent processes for Marion Merrill Dow in the United States and Canada. Jim's leadership and commitment as a chemist, research scientist, and executive at MRI Global is legendary in this region. His service as a civic leader in the design, development, and implementation of the Kansas City Area Life Sciences Institute, now known as BioNexus KC, was instrumental in helping Kansas City become a major national and international player in life sciences and human-animal health. He did it with an eye on excellence, integrity, honesty, national security, public service, and civic pride. But given our subject for tonight's events, I also want to underscore and recognize these amazing people for what they've done to support family life as they've worked hard to advance science, research, technology, and education. Between the two of them, they have blended two families over the course of more than 50 years and raised two generations of children, dedicating themselves selflessly to supporting two adult children through difficult and tragic end-of-life experiences, as they rarely talk about anything other than the blessings that they have been afforded in this life by the community and those that they serve. We have benefited greatly at the center from their contributions, as have all of you throughout this community. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in thanking and congratulating Jim and Lisa Spigarelli with the Center's 2019 Vision to Action Award.
Thank you, John, for those kind words. What a beautiful tribute to Richard, who exemplified the same values as his organization does. Jim and I are truly humbled and honored to receive this award.
Thanks, Lise. When John stopped by to tell us that we've been selected for the Vision to Action Award, I said, "Are you sure?" I had the privilege of being on the Center's Board of Directors for 6 years, and when you're with an organization that long, you develop some takeaways. And for the Center, one is the extraordinary contributions that this small group of dedicated people that make contributions to our community and our society far greater than their size. Also, the tremendous amount of work that these folks do, they put into everything they do, including once a year they do this fabulous dinner, is also extraordinary. But finally, we looked at the quality of people, and I had looked at the quality of people that have been previously chosen for this award. And as Lisa said, we're humbled and honored to join this group. Since we found out it wasn't a mistake, I'd been off the board for a few years, and so I kind of started to look at some facts about my relationship with the center. Not that I have a bad memory, but when you're retired, time goes by really fast. So I pulled up an email that John had written in December of 2012 to Cindy Spaeth, the board chair at that time, and to me, I was going to take over in 2013, that excitedly said that Richard had agreed in principle to join the center while retaining his tenured position at the Duke Medical School. We were really all excited then, but probably not nearly as much as we should have been, because who could have known? Maybe Myra did, because Myra worked with him. But for those of us who hadn't met Richard yet, it was, you could look at the resume, but it was really impossible to understand the impact that he would have on the center and all of us. It didn't matter, actually, the coffee breaks during the board meetings that he attended and we got were better, actually, than the meetings, because you were uplifted by Richard, whether you were talking about sports or the fact those of us who were sort of in the fourth quarter of the game maybe had changing ethics. This ethicist said that. I didn't feel so bad after that. And then talking about grandkids. So no matter what the subject was, Richard lifted your spirits. John mentioned earlier that Lisa and I talk about the blessings we received from our family, having our family, and from the community. And we do say that. And we should say that. And all of us should say that, especially those living in this community, because the icons of Kansas City way back created iconic companies that were based on high ethical standards. Giving back to the community was really in their DNA. So these companies helped create the philanthropic legacy we have now, which makes it fertile ground for important institutions like the center to thrive. So Lisa and I worked for Kansas City companies most of our lives, and because of the kind of community Kansas City is, we think if you give back a little in our community, you're going to get more in return. So thank you very much.
As a tribute to Jim and Lisa, the center will be making scholarships available to our students who participate in the center's educational activities and conferences. So thanks again. Good.